Final Fantasy 13 to with Game on Turtle.
Know what that is, Dodge? That's our home, Cocoon. Must be your first time seeing it from the outside, huh?
Yeah. Cocoon. Daddy!
It reminded me of you, and why I had to go on.
I felt a whirlwind of emotions.
You're the reason I'm standing here.
A large part of it was happiness, and relief was there too. But somewhere inside, I still felt uneasy. Vanille and Fang were gone, and the world hung in silence. Our fight had just ended, but I couldn't relax. A new battle was about to begin. What is that? Oh. Watch out! The events of that day tore open a portal to another world.
Get off me!
And from the depths of the rift appeared a darkness that had no place in our world. An irresistible force that dragged me away to the edge of time. The screams of the dying had unlocked a gate. A door that led directly to the throne of the goddess. Etra waited beyond the gate and sent her miracles to the human world. But a creeping darkness slipped through and threatened to devour our reality. Etro closed the gate and warped the timeline. Time's flow was altered, and existence itself was distorted. I was lost. The darkness caught me in its embrace and wrote me out of history.
That is how she ended in Valhalla. Ended up in Valhalla. Fuck, God.
Where am I? Valhalla. Beyond time. Beyond life and death. A netherworld of shifting gloom. The chaotic realm of the goddess Etro. What power had brought me to this alien shore? From Valhalla's heart, I could track the entire span of time. I gazed upon the future of mankind and sensed Etro's divine will.
Oh no. Okay.
The goddess was fading away. If her spirit should cease to be, the world would descend into entropy. I made my choice. I will fight.
You've been fighting this whole time.
This man, Caius Ballard. He seeks to destroy all hope and bring an end to the future. Though the battle might be endless, I will never give up. Etro has chosen us, her champions, and we cannot fail.
All right.
It all started with Valhalla, is that right? Whatever came from there created the paradoxes, caused the gates to appear, and twisted the timeline.
Lightning! What did you see?
I don't know. It was an enormous power. Something that shouldn't exist in this world. Only Etro can control the power and keep it contained in Valhalla. If she were to disappear, there would be nothing to stop it. And that's what Caius wants. He plans to find Etro sleeping in her temple, kill her, and release the power. The chaos would be unleashed into the world of humans, into our world, through the unseen gate.
A gate?
When a person dies, her soul flies to the other world and passes through that portal. If a great many people die at once, the gate must open wide to let them through.
For example, if Cocoon should fall.
Exactly. It would be unstoppable. The power of chaos would gush through the gate like floodwater through a broken dam.
What would happen to the world then?
Chaos would infect everything. It would become pure entropy, without life, or death, or time.
No life or death? You mean like Valhalla? That's what Caius is after! If he can bring down Cocoon, millions of people would die, and the power of chaos would turn this world into another Valhalla.
Yes. Caius is trying to create a world where time does not exist. If he can erase time...
Yule would be saved. And not just Yule. All the Seeresses down through the ages. They'd be released from their curse. He wants to sacrifice Cocoon to rebuild the world in Valhalla's image, all for the sake of Yule.
That's why you were fighting Caius in Valhalla. You're protecting Etro.
We have to face Caius on two fronts, in Valhalla and in the world of humans. If we don't, we won't be able to change the future. I can't do it on my own. I need your help.
Lightning then told us what would happen to Cocoon. In 500 AF, the old Cocoon would collapse and fall into pulse, the crystal pillar no longer strong enough to support it. By that time, Hope and the Academy would have completed the new Cocoon, but... when they attempted to launch it, Caius would intervene. He would smash it into the old Cocoon and bring them both down. So we have to travel to 500 AF and stop Caius from destroying Cocoon.
If we can change this prophecy, then the true timeline will finally be restored.
Yes. Everything will depend on you. I have to go to Valhalla and stop Caius there. Can you do it?
We can do it.
Right. Your good luck charm will show the way.
Leave it to me, Kubo!
Hey, Lightning. We'll be able to be together again, right? When all this is over?
Sarah.
The truth is, I didn't want to let her go. I'd come so far to find her, I was afraid to lose her again. But I had to be strong, for her sake. She had her own battles ahead of her. So I swallowed the words I wanted to say and hid my fear. It was the hardest thing I ever did.
Lightning is a million times cooler than Sarah. The Moogle hunt is now better than ever. When you spot mysteriously glowing treasure chests, press R1. What? Isn't that the same as what Moogle hunt already does? So I'm guessing we can get this one now. The one that should be right around this corner. Ooh yeah! Yes. Thought for a second it wouldn't work. What we got? Map of New Bodham 700 AF. Oh. So why do we need a map for this? Oh, I'm about to sneeze. This is not good. Complete. Let's go. Oh, I hate sneezing, man. I have a bad problem with sneezing. Alright, we got the artifact. Artifact of the Ark. Of the Ark.
Lightning can't remain beyond the boundaries of Valhalla for long, Kubo.
But still, I was finally able to talk with her.
Can't go in there.
And it's all thanks to Noel.
Let's go keep Hope's new cocoon in one piece. If we pull it off, then Lightning can return fully to her store.
Come on, Mom.
Kabel!
See what we got. Supply sphere access code. Hope's message.
What's this? A message?
Greetings, Sarah in the future.
Greetings.
Can you hear me? I'm sending you the access codes for the supply spheres. The final battle with your ultimate nemesis draws near. I hope the contents are of some use to you.
Good old Hope. He's still helping us fight.
I guess the future is in our hands now.
So I'm gonna have to Google where these supply spheres are. As I have no idea. What the hell is Chocolina doing here? Why is she in every single area? God, she's fucking creepy. She's immortal too, isn't she?
I don't know. I really need your help.
Let's see if you have anything new. Oh, what was that? Oh. Oh wait, she doesn't have a special sections on this, like, version. Or whatever.
Love you.
Yeah, yes, yes. Whoa, get away from me. Get away from me. Get away, get away, get away. Just checking if there's any extra items anywhere. I don't really see any. It looks like most of the area is blocked off. Looking at the map. Alright, so let's take the time gate and find out where it leads. Whoa. Look at this. Oh my god. So fancy. Oh my god. This is like red carpet level ultra high. Yes, I would like to step into the flow of time. Time. Wait, is this the end of the game, or is this just opening up another? I'm hoping it's.
I guess this.
I don't know.
Huh.
We'll find out.
We've been given a second chance by the goddess herself.
We're going to save the cocoon that Hope built.
Yep. And save the future, too.
Koopa! Koopa Bubba!
Alright, so once we get in that gate.
Hey, Caius. You told us you wanted to save Yule by destroying the world. That if you could take away our future, Yule wouldn't have to see any more prophecies and she wouldn't have to die. You really are a fool. Yule never wanted the world destroyed. She never gave in to despair. In the end, when she died, she was smiling. She saw a future of hope. Caius Ballad, I am going to fight you and show you the truth. I'm going to show you the future that Yule really wanted.
Alright, so, Caius Ballad is our new, old, final enemy. So we've unlocked a couple of locations here. What was this? Whoa, it's just a big line of stuff. Okay, so we can go straight to the Academia, or back somewhere. No, not really. But yeah, let's go to the Academia, 500 AF, Academia, why don't they, oh man, it's so hard to say for some reason, but we're going to be doing that next episode on the next time of Final Fantasy XIII 2. Peace out.